She's on Harlem.
I
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
It's a great joy for me to be here at Holy Name Cathedral to celebrate confirmation in the context of the Holy Liturgy with you this evening, brothers and sisters. I'm Bishop Mark Bartosic, one of the auxiliary bishops of Chicago. The incarnation of the Word made flesh and his passion and death makes of all of us brothers and sisters. As we begin Mass, let us call to mind our failure to treat each other as brother and sister. Let us ask of our Lord his mercy. You came to heal the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to forgive sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father where you intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty and merciful God, that the Holy Spirit, coming near and dwelling graciously within us, may make of us a perfect temple of his glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. You yourselves shall be named priests of the Lord, ministers of our God you shall be called. I will give them their recompense faithfully, a lasting covenant I will make with them. Their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, for those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption through which we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Jesus unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives, recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently upon him. And he said to them, "Today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." And all who spoke highly of him were totally amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. The Gospel of the Lord. Candidates for confirmation, please stand after your name is called. And Bishop,
Chaco, Gustavo Ceja, Ivana de la Peña, John Fides, Khalif Jesus Game, Jennifer Gomez, John Thomas Harkins, Jenny Hart, Lenny Hernandez, Stephen Hiltz, Nicole Holland, Savannah Hubley, Indra Jewanate, Daniel Krupa, Emily Lakomsky, Andrew Lee, Courtney Mikowski, Sydney Macias, Jacqueline Martinez, Nicole Melka, Quinn McDonough, Eric Olson, Monica Park, Donatella Pizzulli, Emma Rebelaido, Jasmine Rivera, Juliana Salas Rosa, Joseph Sacchetti, Sarah Setlak, Catherine Ann Sheehy, Nicholas Feikut, Norfred Navadas, Vanessa Tierney, Catherine Valentin, Daniel Venezia.
And Bishop Bartosic, I'm very pleased to present to you to the candidates for confirmation.
Father Sakowicz, have they been prepared and are they ready to receive this sacrament?
These candidates have been prepared for confirmation by participating in the sacramental life of the Church, by meditating on the Word of God, by attending religious classes, by participating in a retreat and other activities, by demonstrating Christian service to all. They have found the strength in God's grace and support in our community's prayer and example. Now they ask to be confirmed and, after consultation with their catechists and sponsors, I testify that they are ready.
My dear sponsors, the Christian life and the demands that flow from the sacraments are not to be taken lightly. Therefore, before granting these candidates their request to receive the sacrament of confirmation, it is important that the Church also hear the testimony of their sponsors, those who have journeyed with them. Are these candidates ready to be confirmed today? I ask the members of the assembly, brothers and sisters, should these, our brothers and sisters, be confirmed today?
Yes.
My dear candidates, your sponsors, your pastor, families, and fellow parishioners have testified on your behalf. Are you ready now to receive the sacrament of confirmation?
Yes.
Please be seated. I go to church a lot. And the earth doesn't always move, you know. But sometimes it does. I was telling you over there that it doesn't matter if it moves for you tonight. What matters is that you believe that God is here. It moved for me just about a year ago. And I was sitting right back there where that potted palm is. It was a big deal mass. And the moment this person began the first reading, which was the reading you just heard tonight, all the hair on the back of my neck stood up. And it was still standing up at the end of mass. I couldn't see. From back there, you can't see who's doing the reading, and it was driving me crazy all the way through Mass, because I was deeply touched, like I'm not very often deeply touched. And I thought, who is that? Tonight we talk about gifts. The person had a beautiful voice. The person was reading with great sensitivity and great intelligence. The person had obviously prayed about it. But it was the Holy Spirit touching me, not the person. Father Sakowicz just read a quotation from that first reading. So the first reading was about Isaiah's vocation. At the very beginning of his vocation as a prophet, he feels that he is known by God. That's what that first reading was about. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me. He's chosen me, in other words. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to announce a year of favor from the Lord. It's at the very beginning of Isaiah's career as a prophet. It's like the Lord is saying to me, hey, Isaiah, I know you. I know you better than you know yourself. I know what you're good for, and I've got something very important that I need for you to do. And then Father Sakowicz read from the Gospel where Jesus chooses that passage from Isaiah to read at the very beginning of his ministry, 3 years before this. He chooses to read that bit about the birth of Isaiah's vocation as a prophet. Hey, Jesus, I know who you are. I know what you're good for. And now is the time to get out there and do it. So I'd been a priest for 27 years a year ago. I had heard that word spoken, that reading, 100 times. But for some reason, the Lord chose to touch me a year ago. And I felt all the way through that Mass, and I still feel today, that I'm good for another 20 years, right? If He knows me, if He thinks I'm good for something, and He tells me, and then He sends me, I'm going. After Mass, you know, all proper, you know, we come over here, we walk down the aisle, and I beat it back here to find out if that person was still there, and he was. And it turned out I know that kid, right? I didn't know what his gift was. He's an amazing lector. You two did a nice job, right? The hair didn't stand up on the back of my neck this time. No pressure. But it doesn't stand up at the back of your neck very often. But the Lord has to know that when he's ready to talk to you, you're ready to listen. And that's what we're trying to do by practicing the Christian faith. There's absolutely no doubt that he knows you better than anyone, and he loves you more than anyone. He knows what you're good for better than anyone, and he wants to tell you. The only way you can stop it is by going like this. I don't want to hear it. And some people do that. As a matter of fact, it's a temptation for all of us. So what is all this about, this being a disciple of Jesus? It's about bearing witness to him. It's about trying through your whole life to put him at the very center of that life. Like to never make a serious decision or any decision without asking him, hey, brother who became like me and gave his life for me on the cross, is this the right thing for me to do? I'm thinking about this or that, which should it be? Stephen Colbert put it this way. I don't tweet, but somebody on my staff sent me a tweet from The Late Show. I think that's the name of his program. And Dua Lipa was on there. I had no idea who Dua Lipa is, but she's sure very pretty. She's a very, very pretty woman. And so this was at the end of January. And she's there and she says, hey, you know, aren't you religious or something? And Stephen Colbert was kind of like, well, this is awkward. But obviously, he's a man who has probably had to give an account of his faith a number of times. So he finally said, well, yes, I am a Christian and a Catholic, he said. And then he said, and that's always connected to the idea that love and sacrifice are somehow related. This is a direct quote. Love and sacrifice are somehow related, and giving yourself to other people, and that death is not defeat. He said a little bit more, but that's a perfect little elevator speech about what we believe. And it's easy to remember. And it's not rocket science. Love and sacrifice are somehow related. If you're raising children, you know this, right? Love and sacrifice are somehow related. If you're trying to be faithful to a spouse, and if you've been trying over years to be faithful and loving to that spouse, you know that love and sacrifice are somehow related. If you're trying to be faithful to a friend who can be a jerk, you know that love and sacrifice are somehow related. But the Christian says, well, yeah, they're related. That's where it comes from. Love comes from the sacrifice of God's life on the cross. That's what the Christian says. That's what the disciple says. There's a pattern. If you want to love, you have to give. It's not about getting. And then he said, giving yourself to other people. That's the importance of gift, the importance of gifts. In a few moments, you'll hear about the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit when I pray that they come into your heart. This kid had no idea. I had no idea. Knowing the kid, he has a gift. It's not something he's probably worked on very hard, you know. I mean, obviously he had thought about it, prayed about it, took his time with it. But it's like being beautiful, right? I mean, you're either kind of really good looking or, nah, not so much, you know? It's the gift you get. What do you do with it? How do you make your life a gift to other people? And maybe most of you are a little bit older, but maybe you do what I think a lot of the eighth graders do, because I do this with a lot of eighth graders. You'd really prefer to have his gifts, you know. When I look in the mirror, it's like, okay, but why can't I be like him? Why am I not like her? That doesn't work if you want to be a disciple of Jesus. That's what they do in the world, but we can't do that if we're going to be disciples of Jesus, because you have the gifts that he wanted you to have. And if he didn't want you to be as pretty as she is, that's too bad. If he didn't want you to be as smart as he is, or to have the beautiful personality, the bubbly, attractive personality of that one, the Christian has a grateful heart, a heart that's grateful for the gifts that he put in you on purpose. And then you make of those gifts a gift of yourself. And yeah, you know, you can work on your weaknesses. That's a good and a noble thing to do. But they're not as important as the gifts that you got. The reason we didn't get all the gifts is so that we need each other. You know, you didn't get an entire package because the Lord wants you on a team. So Stephen Colbert said, I'm a Christian and a Catholic, and that's always connected to the idea that love and sacrifice are somehow related, duh, and giving yourself to other people, and that death is not defeat. We just went through that 2 weeks ago. Death is not defeat. And boy, you and me, if we really had that attitude and we carried it into our workplace and into our house and into our neighborhood, into our parish, this is what we believe. Death is not defeat for the disciple of the one who rose from the dead. So I'm not going to be scared at losing my job or not getting into the high school that I hope to get into, or, for example, not being as pretty as the girl next to me or as intelligent as the guy in front of me, or getting very sick or even dying. I'm not going to be afraid of that, because it's not defeat for somebody who's put the one who died and rose from the dead in the very center of his life. That's what you're signing on for. That's what all of us signed on the day of our baptism, on the day of our confirmation. And the reason we come to receive the Eucharist, the body and blood of Jesus, is so that we will be strengthened so that we can live that way, as people for whom not even death means defeat. This wasn't some theologian, this was Stephen Colbert, right? But it's somebody who both takes his faith very seriously, but even more importantly, he knows he needs to be ready to defend it. He knows he needs to be ready to tell people what he believes and why it makes a difference for him. And none of you who are being confirmed tonight are too young to do that now, today. That's why you're being confirmed. We expect it of you. We expected it of you before, but we expect it of you for real. And of course, not just from you, but from all of us. And it doesn't matter. We were talking about this over there too. It was beautiful. Somebody said it took 40 years. But that's a classic thing for us. All the Lord has to do is to pull the thread and you come back. It takes a second for that to happen. The Christian can always begin again. and again. I began again a year ago. I wasn't looking for it. I thought I was fine, and then all of a sudden, the Lord said, hey, wait a minute. And I still don't know exactly what it meant. All I know is that in a new way, I thought, wait a minute, he knows who I am. He loves me. And he wants me to do something for him. What? Tell me. And that's something we do every day, right? If you believe what I'm telling you, you have to ask him every day, hey, Lord, what am I good for today? And then tomorrow you say, it's Thursday, what about today? And then it's Friday, tell me, what am I good for today? The Holy Father said about 6 years ago, but I just ran across it at the beginning of Lent. He said, during the Christian journey, the journey the Lord has invited us to undertake, there is no saint without a past and no sinner without a future. That's true. And I would say that every one of us, in the morning when we're brushing our teeth, we need to look at that face and we have to love what we see, or we won't be generous. We won't be grateful for something we don't love, and we won't share something we don't feel grateful for. But in that face, we have to see both the sinner with a future and the saint with a past. And we have to be okay with that because he's okay with it. We can only love what is. He's the one who really sees you the way you are, and you're okay for him. There's nobody who can tell you that you're not okay with him. And that's what I think keeps the Christian life dynamic. When you look in the mirror and you can say thank you for that face that you see, that person that you see looking back at you, and you know that it's a sinner with a future and a saint with a past. So if that's what you came for tonight, my friends, if that's what you believe, if you're ready to sign on the dotted line, then I'm going to ask those of you who are going to be confirmed to stand up and to renew the promises of your baptism. Ready? Do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today through the sacrament of confirmation is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Now, candidates, I want you to shut your eyes and keep them closed until I tell you to open them. Fathers, would you come down with us, please? Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with his abundant gifts and through his holy anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these, your servants, to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. You may open your eyes and sit down.
Thank you.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to God the Almighty Father and be of one mind in our prayer, just as faith, hope, and charity, which proceed from His Holy Spirit, are one.
For the Church, that she may continue to be enlivened by the Holy Spirit and spread the gospel message in word and action, we pray to the Lord. For world leaders, that they may use the spirits of understanding and right judgment as they seek to create a world of justice and peace. We pray to the Lord. For those who have been confirmed tonight, that the Spirit may fill them with good things as they continue to give witness to Christ in their life. We pray to the Lord. For parents, sponsors, and catechists, that their witness of the faith may continue to inspire others to follow Christ more closely. We pray to the Lord. For the sick and suffering, that the Spirit of the Lord may wrap them in healing and fullness. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, that they may rest from their labors and rejoice in the face of God forever. We pray to the Lord.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles and willed that through them and their successors the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favorably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that being conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him as they share in the memorial of his redemption by which he gained for us your Holy Spirit. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, Mark, our Auxiliary Bishop, along with all the auxiliary bishops and all those who serve in your faith communities.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness, and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And please be seated for a moment. First of all, a congratulations to all our confirmandi. Very beautiful and special evening. We're proud of all of you and know that our prayers and love will support you on the journey. Special thank you this evening to David Jonas, our director of music. I call him a doctor. He's not a doctor yet. And also with the musicians and the ensemble. How about a beautiful hand for the great music tonight here at Holy Name Cathedral. Also, a special thank you to Dr. Kenneth Ortega, our Director of Faith Formation, does many things at the Cathedral, accompanied by Father Joe Tito, the Associate Pastor. But a hand for Dr. Ortega and Father Joe Tito for the great job they do. Special thanks to one of the youngest priests, the Archdiocese, Father Andy Matijevic, who was ordained last May. He's considered a baby priest, less ordained 1 year, but an outstanding priest. How about a hand for our MC tonight, Father Andy Matijevic. Special thank you to our readers, to our ushers, to our sacristan, Richard Lasowski, and the catechumens, the catechists, the sponsors. Put a hand for all of them for being the great work they did tonight. Thank you very much to all of you. And last but not least, a special, special thank you to Bishop Mark Bartosic, Auxiliary Bishop of Vicariate II. Bishop Bartosic is an outstanding, faith-filled, it was a tremendous homily. In fact, his homily this evening was so outstanding, it sparked with me a line. It really changed my life. I was a high school senior at Notre Dame in Niles. When I heard this line, it kind of changed the course of my life. The line goes like this: our being here on earth is God's gift to us. What we do with our life is our gift back to God. So it directly coincides with Bishop Bartosic's homily this evening. So about a special thank you to a great bishop, the Archdiocese of Chicago, Bishop Mark Bartosic. And Bishop Bartosic said that he will stay afterwards for pictures with each and every one of you. He said that 5x7s will be $8 and 8x10s will be $15. So not a bad price for tonight. God bless and thank you for coming.
We want to thank you too, Father Sakowicz, Monsignor Sakowicz. No? We don't want to thank you? Anyway, it's wonderful to have not only somebody who's good and holy, but who tells ripping good jokes here at the Cathedral. So thank you so much. We love you. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit, and may he keep you worthy of his fatherly love. May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in his church, bless you and confirm you by his power in the confession of the true faith. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of disciples, bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the kingdom of God.
Amen. Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.